Hello students, this is your English lesson. Today we are going to read Unit 12, the Nawab of Salimabad 1. So we start our lesson. First of all, words to know. Cavalry, the part of an army made up of soldiers trained to fight on horseback. Nawab, a title of a nobleman during the Mughal Empire. Regiment, a unit of the army under the command of a colonel. Sir, a respectful form of address for a king or lord. Subjects, people who are under the rule of a king. Wazir, a minister of high rank. A play into acts, people in the play. Storyteller, farmer, the Nawab of Salimabad, farmer's wife. The Wazir, place servant, moneylender, Slim, Hamid and Irfan, the farmer's sons. Act 1, Scene 1, Storyteller. Long ago, the Nawab of Salimabad ruled over a large kingdom. The Nawab was a great man and a good ruler. He treated all his subjects well. He had a palace, a fine army, and two regiments of cavalry. The riders and horses in his cavalry regiments were the best that could be found in his kingdom. He was proud of them. One day, the Nawab was sitting in his Darbar Hall. Nawab, Wazir Sahib, I think that all the people in my kingdom are well and happy. Wazir, indeed they are, sir. Nawab, but some of them are very poor. Wazir, that is also true, sir. Nawab, how can I tell whether those people who are poor are also happy? Wazir, you cannot, sir. Nawab, I shall try. I shall disguise myself in the robes of a traveler and journey throughout my kingdom. I shall see whether people are happy or not. Act 1, Scene 2, Storyteller. The next day, the Nawab dressed himself as a traveler with a warm cloak over his shoulders and a bundle on his back. He walked out of the palace and traveled through his kingdom for many months. He found that some people were good and some were bad. Some were happy and some were unhappy. Some were rich and some were poor. One evening, he reached a small house. The sky was heavy with clouds. His old cloak was soaked with rain. He knocked at the door. Farmer, who is there? Nawab, I am a traveler. May I come in and get dry? It is wet and cold out here. Farmer's wife, come in, dear sir. Farmer, what terrible weather this is. Nawab, indeed, thank you for letting me in. Farmer's wife, you are wet through. Come, take off your cloak and sit down by the fire. Nawab, how very kind you are. Farmer, we are poor farmers, but at least we can allow you to get warm. Farmer's wife, are you hungry? I can give you some roti and some onions if you like. Nawab, thank you. I could do with a little food. Storyteller, the farmer's wife served the Nawab and he ate with great enjoyment. Nawab, that's the best meal I have had for a week. But tell me, why are you so poor? Have you no children to help you? Farmer's wife, well, sir, we have three sons, but they are all serving in the Nawab's army and we are alone. Farmer, we grow a little wheat and onions on our strip of land and manage somehow. Nawab, do your sons ever write to you? Farmer, no, they can't write and we can't read. Farmer's wife, and where they are? We do not know. They all serve in the cavalry. Nawab, how interesting. And what are their names? Farmer's wife, Salim, Hamid and Irfan. Farmer, and they all ride the Nawab's fine horses. Nawab, are you not angry with the Nawab because he takes away your sons for so many years? Farmer's wife, no, no, the Nawab is great and good. We are proud that they serve him. Nawab, well, Thank you for the dinner. Now I must start on my travels again. Farmer's wife. No, no, sir. You must sleep here. You can't go out in this awful rain. Farmer. Make yourself comfortable by the fire and cover yourself with this old blanket. Nawab. How kind of you. Storyteller. The Nawab slept well. In the morning, the old woman gave him some breakfast. The Nawab then went on his way and finally returned to his palace. Now come to the exercises. A. Comprehension. Answer the following questions. A. Why did the Nawab enter the small house? Answer. The Nawab entered the small house because it had been raining and he was wet. B. Why didn't the three sons send letters to their parents? Answer. The three sons did not write letters because they could not write and their parents could not read. C. What is a regiment? Answer. A regiment is a unit of soldiers in the army. D. What made the Nawab's cloak wet? Answer. Rain. E. What did the farmer and his wife grow on their land? Answer. The couple grew some wheat and onions on their land. This question is more difficult. Discuss it first. F. In what ways were the farmer and his wife kind? Answer. The farmer and his wife were kind enough to invite the traveler into their home, make him comfortable by their fire, and give him food, although they had very little. 2. Answer the questions about these lines from the story. How can I tell whether those people who are poor are also happy? A. Who asks this question? Answer. The Nawab asks this question. B. Who is asked this question? Answer. The Wazir is asked this question. C. What answer is given to the speaker? Answer. You cannot, sir. D. How does the speaker find out the answer to the question? Answer. The Nawab dresses himself in the robes of a traveler with a worn cloak over his shoulders and a bundle on his back and walks through his kingdom for many months. 3. Match the following. A and B. There are phrases. We have to make proper sentence. The Nawab of Salimabad was a very great man. He traveled for many months. He wore a cloak over his shoulders. Cover yourself with this blanket. B. Working with words. Choose the correct words from the box to complete the sentences. War, walking, wasted, waiter, whale. A. We often move from one place to another by walking. B. This happens when countries fight each other. War. C. If you don't eat your food, it may be wasted. D. He serves in a restaurant as a waiter. E. A long, loud, sad cry is called a wail. 2. Write the opposites of the following words. You will find the words in the play. A. Cool, warm. B. Ill, well. C. Ashamed, proud. D. Badly, well. 3. Write words with the same meaning as the following. You will find the words in the play. A. Cross, angry. B. Dreadful, terrible. C. In the end, finally. D. Relaxed, comfortable. E. Get by, manage. F. Player, enjoyment. C. Learning about language. 1. Fill in the blanks in the following by changing the words in brackets and sometimes by adding a word too. A. Gold is heavier than paper. B. This book is more interesting than that one. C. Is eating better than sleeping? D. Is stealing worse than hurting people? E. Is a poem more beautiful than a picture? 2. Add articles in the blanks below. Not all the blanks need to be filled. Once upon a time, there lived an ugly miser. He was a very rich man and he grew oranges and apples. He sold them in the market. One day, I asked him for an apple. He said, "I can't give you an apple, but I'll sell you one." "Then give me an orange," I said. I put the fruit in my bag and walked off down the road. 3. Complete the chart using the correct form of the verbs. A. Catch, caught, caught. B. Begin, began, begun. C. Fall, fell, fallen. D. Ride, rode, ridden. E. Send, sent, sent. F. Give, gave, given. Thanks for listening. For new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you like my videos, please share and like.